They say a picture is worth a thousand words, and these old photographs are able to tell much more than what could be said with just a paragraph. Whether intentional or just in the right place at the right time, photographers throughout history have been able to capture incredible moments, both tragic and awesome. Here are some amazing historical photos you must see before you die. Amazing. It's the night of December 5th, 1933. Prohibition is finally over as the 21st Amendment repealed the 18th. The 18th Constitutional Amendment prohibited the manufacture or sale of alcohol within the United States. Ironically, this law ended up leading to a surge of organized crime and alcohol poisoning from bad brews. Secret bars with hidden underground stashes of alcohol probably had some in wait at the time the amendment was repealed. How did these folks know where to get a drink? Surely they couldn't have been there before. Here's Nikola Tesla and his magnifying transmitter in 1899, which he experimented with to design a wireless electrical energy transmitter. Tesla's high voltage generator, which functioned as a resonant transformer, was able to set up electrical conductions with greater intensity than those found in lightning bolts. Its current was capable of lighting over 200 incandescent light bulbs. The image is edited, made up of two separate images, one of the transmitter switched on with Tesla out of the shot, and a second of Tesla sitting down. Still, the photo proves just how ahead of his time Tesla was. This photo was captured in the 1930s, showing a 3-foot grasshopper shot near Miles City, Montana. Except it wasn't. The photo is important because it shows one of the earliest doctored photographs ever created. You should be able to tell it's not real because grasshoppers simply don't get that big. They're usually only an inch or two long. The grasshopper would also cast a shadow on the man's pants and on the ground. The prank photo originally circulated on postcards, and giant grasshoppers seem to be a recurring theme. It continues to fool viewers today as it's often mislabeled online, so it's a reminder for you to question everything you see. This might not look significant, but it is. German U-boats were feared vessels, each capable of inflicting serious damage. UB-110, a submarine during World War I, was sunk in July of 1918 and was salvaged later that year. This photo is from the control room of that submarine during the salvaging process. Here's my question. How on earth did they know which valves to use? On July 20th of 1969, Neil Armstrong became the first man to step onto the lunar surface. Since he was holding the camera, the photos of that event are all of the man who followed him minutes later, Buzz Aldrin. Due to the lack of wind, the little crater on the moon that Aldrin stood in is still there today. This 23 kiloton nuclear explosion, one of two at Operation Crossroads, occurred in July of 1946 at Bikini Atoll. The US intentionally detonated it underwater to assess its damage to naval warships, which were placed at varying distances from the blast, filled with live animals. What's particularly amazing is how effectively it captures the damage of nuclear weapons. Authorities failed to clean up its radioactive fallout properly, leading to people in surrounding areas living, on average, 3 months shorter lives. Here is the annual midnight swearing-in of Nazi SS troops in 1938. SS soldiers were different from regular army troops because they were committed to Hitler and his Nazi philosophy. The oath they took during the ceremony in Feldherrnhalle, Munich read, "I vow to you, Adolf Hitler, as Führer and Chancellor of the German Reich, loyalty and bravery. I vow to you and to the leaders that you set for me, absolute allegiance until death. So help me God." Here's an image from the same ceremony looking in the opposite direction. It certainly has an evil aura. No surprise Star Wars took inspiration from it. This is another fascinating photograph showing a corporal aiming a Colt M1895 atop a Sri Lankan elephant. While there is historical precedence for the use of elephants in warfare for thousands of years, this photo was taken satirically, proving jokes can last decades across generations. The soldiers there were understandably bored. If they had seriously used the elephants, they would have secured the machine gun instead of just placing a tripod on top of it. The least they could have done was give the elephant some giant earplugs. This photo isn't important because of how you'd imagine. It's not an actual execution, but evidence of how powerful imagery can influence people. This is a staged photo of a real event from 1919, depicting the Freikorps executing Eugene Levine, a German communist leader. The firing squad is far too close to the wall to shoot without ricocheting, and they're not aiming or shouldering their guns in such a way that would indicate a readiness to fire. The communist on the left has a defiant attitude, stylish clothing, and great hair, trying to make being a rebel and communist look cool. But it's not, so this was probably sloppy propaganda. This is a shot of the Cathedral of Light in 1937, during the Nazi Party rallies in Nuremberg. The Cathedral of Light was a huge stadium walled in by 152 anti-aircraft bright searchlights, 12 meters apart, facing upwards towards the sky. This wall of lights represented most of Germany's supply of searchlights, which Hitler justified to make the Allies believe they had much more searchlights than they actually possessed. It shows the Nuremberg rallies as a grand event, held each year after with the intent of displaying unity, strength, and commitment to the cause. Allow me to introduce you to Gadget, the first atomic bomb. Looking at this strange wired-up ball, you wouldn't think much of what this weapon would one day become and be able to do. Fat Man, the atomic bomb dropped on Nagasaki 3 weeks later, was similar in design. These German troops are trying to rescue a French soldier from sinking in a mud hole in 1916 during the Battle of Verdun. It shows that despite being enemies, when it came down to it, these soldiers were all human and were all suffering through hell together. Those aren't minions. Those are babies testing out gas masks. Chemical warfare during World War II made it imperative that everyone had protection from poisonous gases. The infant gas mask was made for babies up to 2 years old and covered everything but their legs. The British government required everyone to have gas masks on hand and even gave the children colored ones to make them more fun. That small spot in the middle of the photo is a V1 flying buzz bomb plunging towards central London in 1945. It's amazing to think that something so small could cost so many lives. It almost seems ridiculous. These World War II bombs were short range and were fired by the Nazis from French and Dutch borders. Tony Frisell took this photo of an abandoned boy holding a stuffed toy amid the ruins left by the German aerial bombing of London in 1940. Here's the image colorized. He arrived to this scene after coming home from playing. His parents and brother were found dead under the rubble of his home after it was hit by German bombs. What's especially striking is his expression of both confusion and defiance. The 9-month period of intense German bombings over London and other cities was referred to as the Blitz, which comes from the German word Blitzkrieg, meaning lightning war. They attacked both day and night, killing nearly 30,000 people overall and injuring far more. Millions of buildings were destroyed or damaged. Thankfully, the Axis powers were defeated, and the boy became a truck driver after the war. This image is of a USAF B-25 sinking the Japanese destroyer at Matsukaze on April 6, 1945. This attack tactic is called skip bombing, where a few bombs are dropped from a low altitude. After being attacked by the Allied planes off the coast of China, the crew of the Amatsukaze were able to beach the ship. However, they gave up trying to save it 2 days later, and it was soon destroyed. This is Hans-Georg Hinke, a 16-year-old German soldier. He was only 15 when he joined the Luftwaffe after both his parents died. This photograph shows him crying after his unit had been overrun and captured by American forces. Why is he crying? Because he's just a kid in combat shock who has just seen the worst of humanity. Joseph Goebbels' venomous glare in this photo during a League of Nations conference in 1933 is directed at the photographer, Alfred Eisenstein. It's not because he's camera shy. Goebbels, the greatly anti-Semitic propaganda minister for the Third Reich, had just discovered that the photographer was a Jew. Now that's a picture worth a thousand words. One key Nazi idea was the concept of Anschluss, which called for the annexation of Austria into Nazi Germany. When Adolf Hitler eventually announced in the Kroll Opera House that this eventually happened on 12th March 1938, he received a round of applause, and this image captured the following salute. This had been a long-time goal of Hitler's, so the union with Austria was a big deal. It's significant because Hitler publicly stated in his 1924 autobiography that he would create a union between his birth country and Germany, by any means possible. Hitler was a master orator. This is him rehearsing in front of a mirror. He gave a lot of speeches to the German public, so it seems reasonable that he would want them to be good. The Nazi leader would record and listen to his speeches, and he had his photographer Hoffman photograph his various gestures and poses so he could decide which to use in the speech. After seeing the photographs, Hitler requested Hoffman to destroy the negatives, but he didn't obey. They offer a rare insight into his vanity and controlling personality. These German soldiers are wading through a flooded trench in 1943. While trench combat was essentially obsolete by World War II, due to the development of mechanized warfare, they were still used for defensive, storage, and medical purposes. This photo was from the Battle for Veliki Luki in the Soviet Union. This Auschwitz gas chamber wall appears to be covered with victims' scratch marks. There is debate as to how many of these scratches are authentic and how many may have been added by tourists, but they leave you with a chill nonetheless. The Zyklon B gas that filled the chambers took about 20 agonizing minutes to kill its victims. The blast of heat created by the Hiroshima nuclear bomb was so great that it left an imprint or shadow of some of the figures it incinerated. This person was next to the steps of a bank when the bomb detonated. The imprint remained for over 20 years before it, along with others, were taken to be preserved in a museum. While it looks like a still shot from a movie, this photograph from July 22, 1975 shows Diana Bryant and her goddaughter falling 50 feet from the collapsing fire escape of a burning building in Boston. Bryant ended up dying from her injuries, but her goddaughter survived due to landing on Bryant's body. In the end, this photo received many accolades and prompted positive change for fire escape safety regulations. These German soldiers aren't just watching these videos as a fun movie night event. No, these gentlemen are prisoners of war captured by the Americans, who forced them to watch footage of the horrific acts committed by their fellow Germans, the Nazis, in the concentration camps. This forced process was part of the Allied policy of post-war denazification, meant to purge Germany of the remnants of Nazi rule and rebuild its civil society, infrastructure, and economy. Vladimir Komarov was the solo pilot of the Soviet space capsule Soyuz-1 during its test flight in 1967. During the poorly constructed spacecraft's re-entry back into the atmosphere, Komarov's parachute failed and he was sent smashing into the Earth, leaving him, well, you see the remains. In the wheelchair is Communist Party founder Vladimir Lenin, and this was his last photo. Alongside him are Lenin's sister and one of his doctors. At this point, he had 3 strokes, was mute, and was wheelchair bound. Although he was eventually paralyzed as well, Lenin remained the official Communist Party leader until his death the following year in 1924. These soldiers in the 1st Infantry Division of the U.S. Army are unloading from a landing craft from the USS Samuel Chase. They're heading to Omaha Beach in the midst of the Normandy landings of World War II, D-Day. Over 4,400 of these Allied soldiers were waiting to their death, hence this image being called Into the Jaws of Death. 90% of this frontline company would have been killed or wounded within minutes of battle, as this section of the beach was unexpectedly strong. On May 6th of 1937, Sam Scheer, a news photographer, awaited the arrival of the great and majestic Hindenburg Zeppelin in Lakehurst, New Jersey. What he didn't know was that he would end up capturing one of the most famous images showing what happened next, the massive airship exploding into flames. The event shattered public confidence in passenger-carrying airships, putting an end to the airship era. Seeing photographs of historical moments is the next closest thing to actually being there. Which picture did you find the most revealing? Let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching.